Adaptation in fossa. The habitat of the fossa. They are found in greater population densities in areas of undisturbed forest. Some can also survive in degraded forests, but at much lower numbers. Fossae can be found in virtually every type of forest habitat on Madagascar, including southern spiny, rainforest, and dry deciduous forests. Stractural adaptation. Its coat is short and dense, usually a rich brown color with a golden tinge and a lighter colored belly. The fossa's tail makes up about half of the animal's length. A fossa uses its sharp claws to climb up and down trees while hunting its prey. The fossa is an intelligent, agile animal that moves with ease high up in the trees of its forest home, even though the animal can weigh up to 22 pounds 10 kilograms. That extra long tail helps the fossa balance and jump from branch to branch. Retractable claws like those of a cat and flexible ankle joints help it climb down a tree headfirst. Although it spends a lot of time in trees, the fossa is just as comfortable running flat-footed like a bear along the ground. There is still more to learn about the rare fossa. Until recently, it was believed that fossas were nocturnal because they were so hard to find in the wilderness. Recent studies show that fossas nap and hunt day or night, depending on mood or circumstance. A fossa can travel up to 16 miles 26 kilometers in a day. It is solitary except during the breeding season. As a carnivore, the fossa is an excellent hunter. It preys on small to medium-sized animals from fish to birds, mice, and wild pigs. But lemurs are its main food source, and the fossa is Madagascar's only predator able to kill the largest lemur species. To catch one, a predator must be faster than the lemur, and the fossa can outmaneuver the swiftest lemur. It can jump, scurry, and dash, revealing little more than a tawny blur. The fossa is an ambush hunter. It uses its forelimbs and claws to catch its prey, killing it quickly with a bite from its sharp teeth. The creature feature, 10 fun facts about the fossa. Little is known about fossas, mostly because there aren't many of them, and they live in remote, forested areas. The fossa is Madagascar's top predator, and it looks like a mashup between a cat, a dog, and a mongoose. The fossa Cryptoproctor ferox is the largest carnivorous mammal on the island of Madagascar. They can reach nearly 6 feet in length, with half of that due to their long tails. They look like a cross between a cat, a dog, and a mongoose. Fossas have slender bodies, muscular limbs, and short, reddish-brown coats. They have small, cat-like heads, short, dog-like muzzles, and large, rounded ears. So what is a fossa? 1. Their scientific name means hidden anus. The fossa's genus name, Cryptoproctor, is inspired by how its anus is concealed by an anal pouch. It comes from the Greek for hidden crypto and anus proctor. The fossa's species name, ferox, refers to its exaggerated reputation for ferocity. 2. Fossas are the top predator in Madagascar. Fossas hunt during both day and night, and can take prey from both the ground and in trees. Lemurs make up a good deal of the diets, but they also eat small mammals, fish, lizards, birds, frogs, and insects. 3. Their classification has been complicated. The fossa has features in common with three different families of carnivores, herpestidae, mongooses, viverridae, civets, and their relatives and felidae cats. Recent molecular studies have put the fossa in the Euploridae family, a group that consists of Malagasy carnivores. Members of this family are thought to have descended from mongoose-like ancestors that colonized Madagascar about 20 million years ago. 4. Fossas are mainly solitary. With the exception of mothers with young and brief pairings during the breeding season, fossas are solitary animals. They patrol and defend territories as large as 4 square kilometers. An exception was recorded in 2009, when scientists observed 3 male fossas cooperatively hunting a sifaka for 45 minutes. After they caught the prey, they shared it. The scientists believe this behavior may be a vestige of the cooperative hunting that would have been necessary to take down larger lemurs that existed in the past on Madagascar. 5. Fossas communicate largely through scent glands. Both males and females occupy territories that they scent mark with secretions from glands on their chests and under the base of their tails. Fossas mark rocks, trees, and the ground to communicate and keep track of each other. The glands also release a pungent smell when the animal is irritated or frightened. 6. They also make several kinds of sounds. Fossas mainly vocalize during the breeding season. Females mew to attract males, and males sigh when they have found a receptive female and yowl when competing for her affections. 7. They are agile climbers. The fossa's long, slender tail provides balance as it moves through the trees, and its semi-retractable claws and flexible ankles allow it to climb up and down trees head first. The fossa walks flat-footed on the soles of its feet, like a bear, in a method of locomotion known as plantigrade. This gives them extra balance and stability when leaping from branch to branch. 8. Fossas like forests. Fossas are widespread throughout forested areas of Madagascar, although their population densities are usually low. They can be found at elevations above 2,000 meters. 9. Female fossas are temporarily masculine. The female fossa undergoes a strange developmental stage during adolescence known as transient masculinization, unique to fossas. She develops an enlarged, spiky clitoris that resembles the male's penis, and secretes an orange substance on her underbelly which is usually only seen in mature males. Adult females lack these features. It's unclear what purpose this transient masculinization serves, but scientists hypothesize that it protects juvenile females from either sexual harassment by adult males or aggression from territorial females. 10. Fossas have an unusual mating system. A receptive female occupies a site high in a tree, below which males will congregate and compete for mating rights. She may choose to mate with several of her suitors over the next week, and bouts of copulation may last for several hours. This lengthy mating is partly due to the backwards pointing spines on the male's penis, which results in a copulatory tie that is difficult to break. Once the first female has left, a new female will take over the mating site. The same trees are frequently used year after year. This mating system, in which a female monopolizes a site and chooses her mates, seems to be unique among carnivores.